Want to make your courses and presentations more appealing with content like this? Or like this? Then don't miss this video, as by the end of it, you will know how to create interactive quizzes just by using ActivePresenter. Hey guys, I'm Clay, and in this video, I will guide you step by step on how to design an interactive quiz with ActivePresenter 9. And with 13 ready-made question types, ActivePresenter 9 will definitely wow you with its easy and time-saving creating process. But first, you know what to do. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon here to not miss our helpful content. And now, let's get started. So, the very first step is to insert the question slide. You can open it directly from the question tab or navigate to the home tab, interactions, then choose one among the 13 types. After clicking it, you will see a new question slide appear on the canvas. Okay, so now you will see that each question will have three default components: question title, for you to enter the title of the question. Answer area depends on the question's nature. This means that it may include a list of options if it is multiple choice, dropdowns if it is select in dropdowns, and blanks if it is fill in blanks question. You can also customize the answers, like add by clicking the plus button, delete by pressing delete on your keyboard, or change layout by navigating to the properties pane. Finally, the Submit button. This button is for your learners to submit their answers, and you can also customize its properties as you want. Now, the second step is to set scores, attempts, and time limits for each question. Let's take a look at the score and reporting section in the Interactivity tab. Each question type has two modes: graded and survey. Select the graded mode if you want to evaluate your learner's performance, and select the survey one if you just want to collect their information, opinions, or feedback. Therefore, this also means that the graded mode will have more typical properties than the survey one, which are points, attempts, shuffle answers, and case sensitive. And the functions of these properties, as well as other ones in this section, like timeout, report ID, rating scale, password field, and submit, will be clarified further in the written tutorial that I have placed in the description box below. You can click at the link and find out more about them. Thirdly, and most importantly, to make any object interactable, you have to add events and actions to it. And depending on users' habits, this step and step two above can be changed in order with each other. Now, normally, each question has had its own default events and actions, but remember that you can customize these events and actions by navigating to the Properties pane, Interactivity tab, Events and Action section, and then add, delete, and change them as you want. Finally, to make your interactive quizzes work, remember to export them to the right formats, which can be HTML5, SCORM, or xAPI package in the Export tab. Then a dialog will appear offering you many setting options. But remember to notice the General tab, because in this tab, you are able to set the whole quiz duration, as well as the pass or fail conditions for your online quizzes. So that's it! 4 simple steps, and you have successfully created your own interactive quizzes with ActivePresenter 9. And if you are new to us, the download link of our latest version, ActivePresenter 9, is in the description box. And spend just a few seconds to like, share, and comment your thoughts. And we will be back with more and more helpful videos. And now, goodbye!